Good morning everyone. Today we will see the exercises of chapter 13. Let's see the first one. Choose the ending that gives the most correct meaning. So you have to choose the ending which has the most correct meaning. Before doing this exercise, that is question number 1, please go through the chapter at least 2 to 3 times. Then you will be able to do it easily. Moving to question number 2. Change the sentences using need or needs. You have to change the sentences by using words need or needs. Let's see the examples. The body must have fresh air. The body needs fresh air. So the question is, the body must have fresh air, and then say the body needs fresh air. So in the place of must have, what we have added needs, and rest of the sentence is same. It is, you can see, the body in the place of must have needs fresh air. Let's see second example. We must have different kinds of food. So we need different kinds of food. Again, in the place of must have, what we have used, need. Okay, but how we will decide where to use need and where to use needs? So I am telling you all, please listen attentively. Wherever the subject is singular, that is one, means if we are talking about one subject, one object, or any one thing, there we use needs. Okay, that is singular form of verb. But where the subject is plural, that is more than one, like they, we, boys, girls, children. So in that case, we use the verb need, which is the plural form of the verb. Okay, all of you? Hope I am clear. When the subject is singular, use verb needs. If it is plural, use verb need. Now, let's see some questions. Let's see question number C. A child must have about 10 hours sleep every night. So what will be the answer? A child needs about 10 hours sleep every night. Let's see question number E. We must have food to eat and water to drink. So what will be the answer? We need food to eat. We need food to eat and water to drink. You can see clearly that in the place of must have, what we have used, need. We need food. Sorry for this. We need food to eat and water to drink. If we see question number H. We must have a pen and some paper to write a letter. So what will be the answer? We need a pen and some paper to write a letter. So like this you will have to try. Now let's see question number 3. Look at these examples. Look carefully at the words below. Notice how they change. So first we have to see the example, and we have to go minutely along with the example and see what kind of changes has happened. Now let's see for examples. What is he? So the answer will be, I don't know what he is. Again another question, what is his name? I don't know what his name is. So in all of our answers, what we have to use I don't know. And what his name is. What his name is. So if you rearrange the words of the question, it will become our answer. Let's see another example. What are they singing? So what will be the answer? I don't know what they are singing. Like this, I think you all have done already few exercises. What are they singing? So I don't know what they are singing. So like this you have to change. Now let's see few question. Let's see question number D. What is he saying? What is he saying? So what will be the answer? I don't know what he is saying. Again, I am repeating the answer of this D. I don't know what he is saying. If we see question number I, what are the girls holding? So the answer will be, I don't know what the girls are holding. It's very easy. If you see the pattern of changes. Again, I am repeating the answer of question number I. I don't know what the girls are holding. So like this, you all have to practice this exercise. Now let's see question number 4. Look at the examples and then change the sentences. Begin with I don't know. Again, we have to see the examples and we have to notice the changes happened. And again, we have to start our answer with I don't know. So first, see example. What has she done? Answer will be, I don't know what she has done. What can he sing? The answer is, I don't know what he can sing. If you see here, what he can sing. Again, in the answer, we have rearranged the words of the question. Here also, what has she done? What she has done. So if I see question number D, what have they done? So what will be the answer? I don't know what they have done. Full stop. Okay, if we see question number I, what have the boys drawn? So what will be the answer? I don't know what the boys have drawn. Okay, again I am repeating answer of question number I don't know what the boys have drawn. So like this you have to practice question number 4 as well. I think it's very easy.